Hey guys, what's up? Welcome back to my YouTube channel. And today we have with us Harsh and Arzu on my podcast. And today we are going to be discussing the second sitcom in our series, which is Brooklyn Nine-Nine. Am I right, guys? Am I right?
छोड़ मैं स्टार्ट करता हूँ. चलो सो ब्रुकलिन 99, राइट. सी द रीजन व्हाई ब्रुकलिन 99 इज सो लव्ड, ठीक है, फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल लेट्स लेट्स गेट इन टू दैट. बिकॉज एक तो मतलब मोस्ट रिसेंट शो है एंड इट्स लाइक बहुत बहुत रिलेटेबल है बहुत एस्पेक्ट्स में. अगर कोई लेटेस्ट इवेंट भी होता है तो देख समवेयर कनेक्टेड टू द शो, तो बहुत रेलेवेंट लगता है. अगर पहले की सिटकॉम देखेंगे तो वहां पे उस टाइम के जो एनवायरनमेंट सर्कमस्टेंसेस और सेटिंग्स है उससे अभी के सेटिंग्स काफी डिफरेंट है, तो हम लोग उतना कनेक्ट नहीं कर पाते. बट स्टिल जैसे इफ इफ आई एम वॉचिंग फ्रेंड्स फॉर एग्जाम्पल, राइट, एंड देन दे आर लाइक यू नो फ्लेक्सिंग अबाउट देयर वर्ड डॉक्यूमेंट में पेज बनाना, आई एम लाइक ब्रो दैट्स जस्ट सैड. बट फिर ब्रुकलिन नाइन इज मोर रीसेंट.
अभी जो रिसेंटली यूएस में हुआ, लाइक विद द ऑल ऑल द ब्लैक लाइव मैटर्स प्रोटेस्ट एंड पीपल टर्निंग अप अगेंस्ट द कॉप्स एसेंशियली, एंड ब्रुकलिन 99 इज अ शो वेयर दे पोर्ट्रे द कॉप्स एज ह्यूमंस, दे पोर्ट्रे द कॉप्स एज लाइक वो कॉप्स कॉप बेस्ड कॉमेडी शो है वेयर द कॉप्स आर टेकन वेरी लाइट हार्टेडली. सो आई एम एक्साइटेड टू सी हाउ दे आर गोइंग टू ब्रिंग इन दैट एंगल इन टू द शो, क्योंकि इन वन ऑफ इंटरव्यूज टेरी सेड कि हाँ अभी मतलब सिचुएशन थोड़ी ऐसे स्लिपरी स्लोप है हाउ वी आर गोइंग टू डू इट, बट वी आर श्योर गोइंग टू बी इंक्लूडिंग दैट एंगल इन एज वेल.
They have openly been vocal about racism throughout the show. Be it Captain Holt का angle कि मैं काला था और देखो मेरे को आने में फट गई, you know he I'm black and I'm gay, तो मेरी यहाँ पे आने में देखो मेरे को क्या हालत हो गया. And be it Terry, Terry का even though खाली एक ही incident दिखाया है. And if we are talking about just say the social agendas, वैसे they have many episode dedicated to one of the topics of concern.
लाइक इट एड्स रियलिज्म क्योंकि इट्स बेस्ड इन न्यूयॉर्क एंड लाइक न्यूयॉर्क इज द मोस्ट सॉर्ट ऑफ मिक्स बैग ऑफ ऑल द पीपल फ्रॉम अक्रॉस द वर्ल्ड, राइट? लाइक इफ यू लुक एट द प्रीवियस शो दैट वी डिस्कस्ड फ्रेंड्स, लाइक उसमें दे हैव अ ग्रुप ऑफ सिक्स पीपल एंड ऑल ऑफ देम आर वाइट एंड दे आर लिविंग इन न्यूयॉर्क. ऑल द पीपल द सपोर्टिंग कैरेक्टर्स ऑल्सो ऑल ऑफ देम आर वाइट. Now coming back to the episode, like जिसके बारे में बात कर रहे हैं, okay? So like who's your favorite character? Okay, first Arzu, you go first. Who's your favorite character from Brooklyn Nine-Nine?
I think my favorite character would be definitely Rosa.
Hello.
I really, really love her. And I think I can be gay for her, no doubt.
Yeah.
But one thing which I really like about her is how she has been. There have been certain emotional moments of Rosa, and she has been one of the realest characters. Okay, she has stick to her principles always, and she has been very real to everyone. Everyone. She doesn't. She never sugarcoats. She is the most straightforward person, and she's there for. She has everyone's back. You know how she told Sammy, "I have your back."
Yeah, you missed a joke where you just said she's the most straightforward person, but also bi. So. अच्छा जोक होता. बट ऑल्सो लाइक टॉकिंग अबाउट रोजा, द एक्टर हु प्लेज रोजा, स्टेफनी बियट्रिस, लाइक हर रियल लाइफ पर्सोना इज द एग्जैक्ट ऑपोजिट ऑफ वॉट रोजा इज. लाइक शी इज सो स्वीट, शी टॉक्स लाइक एन 18 year ओल्ड, लाइक शी इज सो स्वीट एंड क्यूट इन रियल लाइफ, बट वेन शी चेंजेस टू रोजा इट्स जस्ट द ऑपोजिट.
I don't know if I'll be going against the public opinion, but Rosa is very hot. Stephanie
Yeah.
Beatrice, for some reason, is annoying to me.
Yeah,
Even her
yeah,
voice is
yeah.
doing this. I'm like, no, please don't. Like,
Yeah.
कान में चुभ रही तेरी आवाज अब.
Who's your favorite character, Harsh?
So my favorite character is Jake. The reason because there are many aspects of my life where I relate to him, be it workplace, or you know. हाँ, बी इट वर्क प्लेस मोस्टली बिकॉज दैट लाइक ही इज अ he doesn't take things seriously, but yet he gives the results. And it's like the same lame jokes, same pranks. And I have Holt as a boss, and I have Hitchcock as a colleague. So it all just sums up.
It's nice
Yeah.
that you brought up Hitchcock, because I was gonna say he's my favorite character. Like Hitchcock and
Yeah.
Scully both.
I think to imply him in your life as
Yeah,
well.
like
I don't
Hitchcock
know.
Scully both, man. Like if you उनका तू देखेगा वो 1980s 1970s वाले जो उनके एपिसोड थे, दे आर लाइक कितने हॉट, लाइक क्या सेक्सी उनकी वॉइस, लाइक हाउ दे बीट अप द बैड गाय, हाउ दे टॉक टू द वेटरेस एंड ऑल, लाइक क्या हॉट. एंड व्हेन यू लुक एट देम नाउ, फक, लाइक आई रिलेट टू देम मैन, आई रिलेट टू देम ऑन अ स्पिरिचुअल लेवल. लाइक बड़ा होके मुझको ये बनना है, दैट्स माय थिंग.
ऑलरेडी आर देयर, तुम अभी ही स्कली फॉर्म, यू आर स्कली राइट, यू आर हिचकॉक एंड स्कली राइट
I'm
नाउ.
Hitchcock and Scully from the 1980s right now. I don't know how you guys are not seeing that.
I'm just hoping Himanshu will have a reverse Hitchcock Scully, where he goes back from being 2020 to 1980 का Hitchcock Scully.
Yeah, and like Hitchcock and Scully का मुझको एक मोमेंट याद है वेर दे बोथ आर लाइक, वो कुछ तो भी टीम मीटिंग चल रहा है एंड होल्ट इज दे आर ट्राइंग टू फाइंड आउट समथिंग, अ ओल्ड वुमेन इज ट्राइंग टू से, शी इज स्पीकिंग इन चेकोस्लोवाकिया, लाइक आई डोंट नो व्हाट लैंग्वेज इट वाज, सो शी इज ट्राइंग टू डिस्क्राइब समथिंग, सो शी मेक्स अ सर्कल एंड पुट्स डॉट्स इन टू इट. So Hitchcock says it's a cookie. Scully says it's a pizza. They both say it's a cookie pizza, and they walk away. Holt is,
personalities of
yeah.
Himanshu, and also like how Scully and Hitchcock are polar opposites, you know, unka nature, and they both cancel each other. Yeah? Like I Hitchcock is my least favorite character, and Scully can easily be one of my favorite characters as well. Scully so adorable, and Hitchcock is so creepy, and they both cancel each other.
Who is your favorite recurring character on the show?
Okay, let me just take a wild guess and say everybody's gonna say Doug Judy. So,
Judy.
yeah.
No,
Yeah.
for me it's Kevin. For me it's Kevin. I really like him. I really want to see more of him.
केविन, बट केविन इज नॉट अ रिकरिंग कैरेक्टर. वो है ना, वो मेन कास्ट वगैरह में है ना.
नहीं, केविन
केविन हर सीजन एक या दो
ओके
में आता है.
लाइक एंड दैट गाइस सो द एक्टर हु प्लेस केविन इज एक्चुअली अ राइटर ऑन द शो.
या ही
सो आई डोंट नो, इट मेक्स मी वेरी हैप्पी व्हेन आई सी दैट यू नो वन ऑफ द राइटर्स ऑन द शो इज एक्चुअली आल्सो अ कास्ट मेंबर. लाइक द सेम हैपेंड विद माइकल शर. लाइक दे अंडरस्टैंड द एसेंस ऑफ दैट कैरेक्टर ना, बिकॉज़ दे हैड समथिंग इन देयर माइंड व्हेन दे वर थिंकिंग दैट कैरेक्टर आउट. सो और ऑब्वियसली डग जूडी. हिमांशु तेरा भी डग जूडी?
हाँ यार, डग जूडी, लाइक वो जेक, लाइक नॉट डग जूडी एज डग जूडी, बट डग जूडी एंड जेक का जो मोमेंट्स वगैरह रहता है ना, वो अच्छा है. लाइक नॉट डग जूडी एज अ कैरेक्टर, बट उन दोनों का डायनामिक, लाइक वो इतना प्यारा है देखने में.
अमेजिंग केमिस्ट्री. आई रिमेम्बर दिस वन सीन फॉर एग्जाम्पल वेर दे आर लाइक वर यू लुकिंग एट टूडी जूडीज ब्यूटी. I was not looking at Trudy Judy's booty, but I was on beauty. She don't think she's a cutie. Don't be snooty. And it's like, oh my God, it's such a fucking amazing show. And like,
But I honestly relate to Doug Judy the most when he's simping for Rosa. I mean, Doug Judy at Rosa is me at Rosa.
One thing that I really like about that part, that storyline where Doug Judy simping for Rosa. They show it in such a beautiful way ki haan, while I'm simping for you, consent is very important. You know, he doesn't cross the line.
is this scene where Doug Judy's mom braids Rosa's hair, and Rosa just simply takes one of the strands and she cuts it. And Doug Judy immediately is like, he's happy. That is the I have related it so much.
मैन. एंड ऑल्सो ही इज सो काइंड हार्टेड. लाइक वो ऐसे जेक का करियर फकअप करेगा, बट ही विल ऑल्सो ट्राई टू सेव इट. लाइक वो डायमंड्स चुरा के लेके गया, बट वो रखेगा वो कैरियो के बार में, एंड ही नोज कि जेक कैरियो के बार में आएगा, लाइक वो प्लेस में आएगा, देन ही विल हैव टू सिंग विद हिम. So he has the pre-recorded messages. He has, he knows how Jake is gonna feel. He know how he's gonna react.
और मेरे को ना वो पार्ट बहुत अच्छा लगा था, वेरी ही हैज द प्री रिकॉर्डेड मैसेज, बट वो प्री रिकॉर्डेड मैसेज सिंक नहीं हो रहा. इट्स
हाँ
लाइक रिस्पोंडिंग एंड इट्स लाइक दैट्स राइट, आई एम लाइक ओ ओके. सो टू थिंग्स हियर हिमांशु, वन इज दैट आरजू हैज लेफ्ट, आरजू हैज समथिंग अर्जेंट टू अटेंड टू, शी विल नॉट बी कंटिन्यूइंग ऑन दिस पॉडकास्ट. एंड सेकंड इज I have, let's like, since I have taken Doug Judy, I don't want you to take the same character. So like someone else that you can think of.
There's not just one else. Like there's Pimento, of course. I also like the Vulture. Like Vulture ka character bahut pyara hai. And Madeline Wunsch, if you remember. And no spoil, like spoiler alert. Just skip like 20-30 seconds, guys. Madeline Wunsch died in the latest season, right?
Yeah, I know.
So like,
yeah.
The way Holt reacted when he got the news, Madeline Wunsch has died. It's so natural. Like he is devastated, but also he has the soft spot for her, even though she has been like one of his greatest nemesis. So. Madeline Wunsch बहुत सही है. एंड कमिंग बैक टू पिमेंटो, आई जस्ट लव हाउ पिमेंटो इज पोर्ट्रेड. लाइक ही इज एबनॉर्मल बट ऑल्सो एवरीबॉडी ट्राइज टू इंटरैक्ट विद हिम लाइक ही इज अ ह्यूमन. लाइक वो ऐसे आधा किलो कोकेन मार के घर में घूम रहा है एंड एवरीबॉडी इज लाइक या दैट्स पिमेंटो राइट. लाइक वो एंड द केमिस्ट्री बिटवीन पिमेंटो एंड रोजा. Like the first time they interact when Holt ka kutta ghum jata hai, like they are told to post flyers on the walls, and unka jo chemistry hai, where they are like I wanna lick your face off and all of that, and when Rosa actually confesses that to Pimento, he just runs away.
Like that is exactly what I want. That is the kind of a relationship. Like. That relationship was so toxic. It was a turn on.
Yeah.
I don't know. I think for toxic things, but that's there. And a god, recurring character who is actually dead now, in real life. It's Cheddar.
Oh yeah. Oh shit. Cheddar died. Yeah.
Yeah. Wow. Yeah. Cheddar died. So that's like he sahi character tha. It's like, you are not Cheddar, you're just a basic
yeah
bitch.
Like that's the only like wo Cheddar jab bhi bolta hai, that's the first thing that pops into my head. Like how everybody just knows ki Cheddar and Holt walk in a straight line and Cheddar walks behind Holt. Like it's just so cute to watch Cheddar and Holt.
So now that we're talking about Doug Judy, for example, and how, see, Doug Judy is clearly one of the main people in Jake's life,
yeah.
Right? Because it's like they're best friends, but they don't often talk much. And Jake has another best friend, which is Charles Boyd. And Udka bhi friendship, alag level ka. Because trust me, I'm lucky to have a few boys in my life. And I know what it's like having a boy. Like they're so selfless and... at the same time, like they have no boundaries, and it doesn't even matter that they don't have boundaries, because it's like you know that they have the best intentions at heart, and you have to sort of, you know, be a parent to them while they are like a guardian figure in your life. It's a very beautiful relationship. And then there's Doug Judy, right? So what if Doug Judy was actually at Jake's wedding?
Oh man, like no, but Doug Judy, man, like I wanted him to be like, I wanted to see the interactions between Boyle and Doug Judy, like at Jake's wedding, for being the best man, for doing all the stuff around it. Mango itna pyara hota. And Jake and Amy wedding is by far the most beautiful thing I've seen in all the shows that I've seen. Like it's the most beautiful wedding ever. Like wo aise baraf mein, it's in open air. Like wo sab, the music playing in the background, Milip knows playing the music, Milip Clay knows. his name. Like I just love how everything just comes together. And उसपे एमी का एक्स आता है उधर with the bomb squad का robot and Jake. Like वो it's so cute to watch, man. And of course, Melissa Fumero looking gorgeous. Like नहीं इतना क्यूट कोई कैसे हो सकता है यार, लाइक क्यों.
I know. And then there is that iconic line like your butt is the bomb and there will be no survivors.
Yeah.
It's so cute. But yeah. So and like the Jake and Amy का relationship is very wholesome. It's very heartwarming. I really like every scene basically that has Jake and Amy in it. For example, there's this one scene that I really really love of the show is when they're at the rooftop and Amy is about to go give her exam. And she's out, and Jake comes there. It's like because this is a place that you fell in love with me, and Amy is like really. And then he says, "Okay, the place like the one time when you flirted with me for 15 seconds, and I became obsessed with you forever." And it's so fucking cute. Because that happens, that complete peanut scene. It was so cute. And that like the 15 second flirting thing is it's real. It's real.
In the very first episode, when you look at Jake and you look at Amy, even though they are not dating, even though they are like rivals at that point, but you know ki inke beech mein kuch hone wala hai. And the way they set it up till I think third season mein is when that happens. The way they set it up is just so amazing, yaar. Like it's one of the best couples to watch on TV, man.
But while we're talking about couples, one more thing that I want to point out here is ki Jake and Amy ka jo relationship hai, it is very stereotypical and generic relationship, right? I mean, it's a very progressive relationship, and it's a very, it's not a codependent relationship, it's a very nice relationship. But then idea of love between them is something that's a little known or, you know, a little something that we're used to. Another relationship on the show that I want to talk about is Holt and Kevin.
When you say Holt and Kevin ka relationship, na, I just go back to that one scene where Holt and Kevin just shake hands in the middle of the office, and Kevin's like, "Oh, PDA at work," and Holt is like, "Oh, I can't help myself." That's just so pure. Like when you know their backgrounds, when you know how they like, when you know their lives, how they interact with people, and when they say these lines, it's just so funny and so contextual.
Uh-huh, exactly. Na wahi hai ki na, it's like a very pure definition that, you know, love comes in all forms. And it's not just that they're gay or anything, but it's just that, you know, everyone's way of expressing love is different. For you, probably going on a tower and having a loudspeaker in your hand and screaming out the other person's name is love. But for the other person, it's just, you know, whispering her, like the partner's name from the end of the room, and then, you know, just look, having eye contact, and that's love. So, which is bahut acche se explain kiya, that it doesn't have to be extravagant in every case. Which is your favorite episode?
Fuck, favorite episode? I don't think there's any favorite episode, but it's just one of the bits that they do throughout the show is the Halloween heist, which is like so amazing to watch, and the way it progresses every year. Like you just think there's no way they're gonna top the last season, but they do. And like oh, itna sahi se hota hai. I just love how everybody knows ki haan ye hone wala hai. Like everybody knows ki acha ye apne table ke niche se paddle karke ek pura server utha raha hai. Like wo sab, like everybody is just so casual about it. And I just love all the Halloween heists. There's no picking one heist, but all the Halloween heists are just so good.
I think this is with every show. Okay, like every show has this one holiday that they've picked up. For example, Friends mein they have Thanksgiving, and The Office mein they have Christmas, and Nine-Nine mein they have Halloween. And there's just no, that's like a like every Halloween you will watch the episodes from Brooklyn Nine-Nine, and Thanksgiving you will watch the Friends ka Thanksgiving episodes, and Christmas mein you have The Office. So that's cute. But and that's my favorite recurring storyline as well, the Halloween heist. And but at this point, I think na zyada ho gaya.
ये वाला जो सीजन था, द सेवेंथ सीजन, द लेटेस्ट वाला जो हेरोइन हाइस्ट था, वाज अ बिट टू मच. लाइक मुझको तो भी लाइक एट दिस पॉइंट वी आल्सो नो हु इज गोना विन, राइट? लाइक जो नहीं जीत तक वो जीतने वाला है, वी नो दैट. एंड इट वाज अ बिट टू मच क्योंकि सब कुछ हो गया है अभी, देयर इज नथिंग न्यू दैट दे कैन डू दैट. लाइक उनका भी वो प्रॉब्लम है, बट फिर भी यार वो बहुत ज्यादा लग रहा था इस सीजन.
बट ओके माय फेवरेट एपिसोड नंदलेस ओके व्हिच इज लाइक शियर ब्रिलियंट एक्टिंग बाय एवरीवन इन्वॉल्व्ड एंड स्पेशली द पर्सन हु मेड द कैमियो इज द एपिसोड विद स्टर्लिंग के ब्राउन. तो स्टर्लिंग के ब्राउन का सो आई एम अ ह्यूज स्टर्लिंग के ब्राउन फैन एवर सिंस आई हैव सीन हिम इन दिस इज अस. ही इज एन एक्सेप्शनल एक्टर एंड उस एपिसोड में द complete aura that he is giving out. मतलब you look at him and you're like, okay, this is not a person easy to crack. मतलब he just walked the precinct and he fucking owned the precinct. वैसा so I love that episode.
And the dynamic that they show between Holt and Jake, like first they try good cop bad cop, फिर Jake ऐसे like Holt भी, I think Holt was getting ready to go to an opera with Kevin, which is like one of the best things that could have happened to his life, but he refuses to go there. He's like मेरे को ये करना है, मेरे को मजा आएगा इसमें. Like fuck, वो एपिसोड सही में बहुत सही है. एंड इट्स आल्सो वन ऑफ दोस एपिसोड्स व्हिच इज शॉट इनसाइड अ रूम. लाइक देयर बेयरली 1-2 मिनट का आउटसाइड वाला सीन्स, बट इट्स कंप्लीटली शॉट इनसाइड अ रूम विद जस्ट 3 एक्टर्स, विच इज ब्रिलियंट. लाइक उसके लिए कितना लिखना पड़ा होगा उनको, कितना वो इतना सही उन लोगों ने दिखाया है. इट्स जस्ट ब्रिलियंट. एंड द ट्विस्ट एट द एंड वेयर जेक इज लाइक यू आर जस्ट टू स्मार्ट टू एक्सेप्ट दैट यू मेड एनी मिस्टेक्स, वो सब लाइक
So, all this apart, there is one character that we haven't talked about much, Himanshu, and that character is apparently how do I put this delicately, glorified a lot, and I don't think she's worth the hype. It's Gina.
Oh
So,
man.
yeah,
Oh
Gina.
man, no.
Popular opinion. I don't like Gina a lot. Like I get it, the sass and everything. It's like it feels really good to relate to it. But then I look at Gina and it's just a very toxic character to have. It's a very
Yeah, man. Like I don't understand the people who are like, oh my god, I relate to Gina. I'm like, yeah, you are annoying. Yeah, you're right. If you're watching it from a third person perspective, like Gina is being annoying to other people, it's okay. Like you get it. But for actually being Gina or having somebody who aspires to be Gina in real life around you, it's just fucking annoying. Like वो बहुत annoying है यार. And they've tried to put her in as the millennial character, like वो Gen Z वाला character, like who is a who has like 50,000 followers on Twitter, who is an influencer and all. But उन्होंने उसको कुछ ज्यादा ही millennial बना दिया है, to a point where it's not even real anymore, right? Like it's a
And
police precinct. You can't do shit like setting things on fire here. Like, तो कैसे कर रही है ये सब?
उसका जैसे सी हियर्स द थिंग इट फील्स गुड लाइक आई गेट इट दैट इट माइट फील गुड टू बी जीना बिकॉज लाइक यू नो यू आर जस्ट गिविंग एवरीवन शिट एंड दे आर टेकिंग इट लाइक यू नो व्हेन आई डाई टर्न माय ट्वीट्स इनटू अ बुक ओह दिस इज मी ओह नो बट आई हेट द थिंग इट्स अ फकिंग टॉक्सिक कैरेक्टर. फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल She makes Terry very uncomfortable by unnecessarily sexualizing him. It's like just take off your shirt and you know, oh those pecs, oh those. And like the same thing when Hitchcock does, it's creepy. So वहाँ पे थोड़ा सा double standards, and then Gina is a very bad friend to Jake and Terry in the last season.
To
And
everyone, basically, like I don't remember her being a good friend to anybody. Like maybe when Rosa was coming out, she was like वो woke वगैरह, इसलिए वो एंगल प्ले किया. But other than that, she's a very bad friend.
And when she does the bare minimum, it's like, oh, you know, Gina did it. No, that should not be the standard that you people hold you up to. Oh, she did the bare minimum. Let's fucking praise her for that. That is not how it should happen. Amy is kind to her and she is always mean to her unnecessarily. And uska kahin na kahin self-respect demolished sa kar rahi hai Gina. And then she is like, you know, she tries to act cool. Like even when it happened with Boyle, right? Uska Boyle ke saath kitna, like you on one hand you are sleeping with him and on the other hand you're making him feel like shit. Like usko itna inferiority complex de diya. If you say it out loud without context, people would be like, oh, you know what, girl power, this is what, like, you know, you are like that's what challenges your masculinity and everything. No, dude, it's not about that. It's just that the person is toxic. It's like it doesn't even have anything to do with her being a girl. Even if it was a guy, it would be equally toxic.
Yeah, and we are not saying ki Gina is a bad character. Like, for a character in a show, it's a good thing to watch. It's funny, okay? For a character, when you're watching it in a third-person perspective, it's good to see. But you shouldn't aspire to be Gina. You shouldn't be like, main bhi badi hoke aise karungi. Like, wo galat hai, mat kar. Rakh de wo cement niche. Like, nahi, aise nahi hota kahi pe. तो क्यों ऐसे क्यों करना है तुमको जिंदगी में कुछ पढ़ाई वढ़ाई करो आईएएस वाईएएस बनो लाइक वैसा नहीं चलता
तुम इंस्टाग्राम पे रील्स बनाने से कुछ नहीं होगा ओह ओके एंड ऑन अ कंप्लीटली अनरिलेटेड नोट आई जस्ट वांटेड टू पॉइंट आउट दिस वन थिंग सो जेक एंड एमी का रिलेशनशिप इज वेरी होलसम राइट एंड बट एंड यू नो जेक ऑब्वियसली ग्रोज अ लॉट इन दैट रिलेशनशिप विदाउट पुटिंग इट ऑल ऑन एमी लाइक एमी डजंट हैव टू बेयर द बर्डन ऑफ जेक ग्रोइंग अप बट there's this one scene that I really like where Jake actually in the episode she said Amy is very invested in that case and Jake actually makes conscious efforts at making himself a better person for Amy because he understands that you know things from her perspective and you know, just to and even if he doesn't he tries to and he watches a documentary and that's like one of my favorite scenes because there's this one point where Jake says that, you know, every time you understand it's how bad it is, you know, every time you think that it can't go any bad, it gets much worse. And that's like, that's true because, you know, terko hi pata, mereko hi pata. We know guys, like all of us know guys who are like, haan, agar iska aaya kuch to pata hai ki haan, ye creepy hai. Like, haan, we know for a fact that this guy probably makes women feel uncomfortable.
Yeah, man, and the thing that you said, ki how he grows up in the relationship, like wo angle se, we've seen a lot of relationships go that way. But also, I'd like to point out how real and at the same time unreal it is. Because I think we've all had that one relationship where we are like the girl maybe likes how childish we are, how funny we are, and like. We try to make our constant efforts to make her feel good, to make us feel validated at the same time to make her feel good. And it doesn't always end up like Jake and Amy, just to tell you guys. Like, unka alag aise real life mein shaadi nahi hota hai, theek hai? Like, wo kuch zyada hi, for the show, wo log kuch zyada hi stretch kar gaye usko. And this happens in case if you look at the previous show that we discussed Chandler and Monica wo log bhi shaadi karke khush ho gaye it doesn't end up like that guys spoiler alert
ha matlab wo bahut wo na bahut fantasize kar matlab na usko bahut romanticize kar diya us idea ko
we'll address it again Arzu is back guys
to conclude Arzu like do you have any concluding points on the complete podcast to wrap it up
okay in all it's a really sweet show and I think it like we our generation currently needs the show we have all kind of edgy shows and all kind of bigotry related shows but this show we need this show so and it also serves a purpose of humor without being edgy like you can be funny without being edgy so yes our generation Gen Z needs this show
so I want to end this podcast by, you know, the way we should, like a 99 podcast should end. So at the end of it, I want, like, you know, all of us to say 99 the way Terry does.
Nahi yaar, nahi, kyun yaar?
What cringe ho jayega? Hold up.